Hi everyone! Today we're going to talk about how to prove the derivatives of inverse hyperbolic identities. To complete this problem, we'll use algebra to manipulate the derivative equation and then simplify as much as possible to prove the derivative. Let's take a look. In this particular problem, we've been asked to show that the derivative of inverse hyperbolic sine is equal to 1 divided by the square root of 1 plus x squared. And normally this would just be a definition or an identity that would be given and we'd take it for granted, but in this case we need to prove that this is true. One of the formulas we're going to use is a very common identity that we know, which is hyperbolic cosine squared of x minus hyperbolic sine squared of x is equal to 1. Remember that we need to show that the derivative of inverse hyperbolic sine here is equal to what we have over here on the right hand side, so we're going to hone in on the derivative of inverse hyperbolic sine. The way that we're going to do that is for now, we'll just set y equal to inverse hyperbolic sine, and we'll take it from there. So now that we've got this in the form of a function, we want to go ahead and simplify and then take the derivative. So the way that we'll simplify is by taking the hyperbolic sine of both sides. So we'll take hyperbolic sine of both sides and we'll get hyperbolic sine of y. When we take hyperbolic sine over here on the right, it will cancel with inverse hyperbolic sine and we'll just be left with x. Now, remember that we're driving toward the derivative of inverse hyperbolic sine. So we want to go ahead and take the derivative of what we've got here with respect to x. So this is going to be implicit differentiation and we're going to take the derivative of both sides with respect to x. Taking the derivative of the left-hand side, remember that the derivative of hyperbolic sine is hyperbolic cosine, so we'll get hyperbolic cosine of y, but because we're using implicit differentiation to take the derivative with respect to x, we have to use chain rule, and whenever we take the derivative of y, we have to go ahead and multiply by dy over dx, and that's a rule of implicit differentiation. So we multiply by dy over dx. On the right-hand side, taking the derivative of x with respect to x is totally normal. We just get 1. Now we want to go ahead and solve for dy dx by dividing both sides by hyperbolic cosine of y. So we'll get dy over dx is equal to 1 divided by hyperbolic cosine of y. What we have now, 1 over hyperbolic cosine of y, is the derivative of inverse hyperbolic sine. We just need to get it in the same form as what we have over here on the right-hand side. So we've got 1 in our numerator. We need to just modify or change the denominator from hyperbolic cosine of y to the square root of 1 plus x squared. The way that we'll do that is with the identity that we've written up here, or this formula that's common that we know. We're going to switch this around to solve for hyperbolic cosine of x, in this case, with our formula. So we'll do that by adding hyperbolic sine squared of x to both sides. So we'll get hyperbolic cosine squared of x is equal to 1 plus hyperbolic sine squared of x. Now we want to take the square root of both sides and we'll get hyperbolic cosine of x is equal to the square root of 1 plus hyperbolic sine squared of x. So we've got that there. We can now plug in what we have on the right hand side for hyperbolic cosine of y. The fact that x and y are different here is irrelevant. We have x here because it's just a formula. So what we get when we plug that in is 1 over the square root of 1 plus hyperbolic sine squared of y. And now, as you can see, all we need is a way to simplify hyperbolic sine squared of y. The way that we do that is by taking this step right here and squaring both sides. So if we square both sides, we'll get hyperbolic sine squared of y is equal to x squared. We can see here that we have hyperbolic sine squared of y and hyperbolic sine squared of y, so we can go ahead and make the substitution for x squared and get 1 divided by the square root of 1 plus x squared. And that's it. We've shown that the derivative of inverse hyperbolic sine is 1 divided by the square root of 1 plus x squared and proven that identity. So I hope you found that video helpful. If you did, like this video down below and subscribe to be notified of future videos.